Today in this module, we will study how to search and evaluate open educational resources. In the previous module, we learned that open educational resources are such educational or research materials which allow anyone to use, share, or modify. This may or may not include its commercial use. The OER are available, as we learned, in a variety of formats. For example, activities or assignments, lab assessment, homework assignment, class guides, student guide, syllabus, courseware, full course, lecture, lesson, module, units of study, instructor materials, lesson plans, teaching or learning strategy, mixed media, diagram, illustrations, games, interactive, simulation, reading materials such as case study, data set, lecture notes, primary source like reading textbook, like that. These are openly available for use by educators and students without an accompanying need to pay royalties or license fees. There are billions of open licensed materials available on the internet. So the question is, how do we search them? Let's understand searching and evaluating the quality of open educational resources. So in this module, you will identify open educational resource repositories, and after the completion of this module, you will be able to use various OER search engines for searching open educational resources. You will be able to use advanced search for locating open educational resources, and you can evaluate the quality of an OER. Now, how do I contribute a common license work as Creative Commons? A good rule of thumb is to recall the acronym TAL, that stands for Title, Author, and License. Title means what is the name of the material. Please provide the title of the work you are adopting. Be sure to hyperlink the title to the original source. And if a hyperlink is not available, describe where you got the work. The second is author. Who owns that material? Please name the author or authors of the material in question, which you have referred to. Sometimes the licensor may want you to give credit to some other entity, like a company or a pseudonym. In those cases, please just do what they request. Also, if the author has a web page, please link to the author's page. And the third of TAL is license. How can I use it? Please provide the exact name of the Creative Commons license under which the work has been released, and the hyperlink the license name to the license deed page. You can use the acronym instead of full name on the license. And you are obviously using the material for free thanks to the Creative Commons license, so make note of it. Don't just say the material is Creative Commons, because they say nothing about how the material can actually be used. Now let us have a look on the OER repositories. They can be classified into general textbook repositories or general OER repositories. We can simply go to their website and search the required content from the search box given there on the sites. Let us see some of the most popular repositories. One is the multidisciplinary open textbook repositories, like the offered by Community College Consortium for Open Educational Resources, popularly called as CCCOER. It promotes the awareness and adoption of open education policies, practices, and resources. It is a growing consortium of community and technical colleges committed to expanding access to education and increasing student access through adoption of OER policy, practices, and resources. And they provide a community and resources to learn about evolving practice of open education. Another example is Galileo Open Learning Materials. they bring together open educational resources throughout the university system of Georgia, including open textbooks and ancillary materials. This repository is administered by Affordable Learning Georgia, an initiative of Galileo and the University System of Georgia, which aims to reduce the cost of textbooks to students and contribute to their retention, progression, and graduation. The third is Global Textbook Project, which is a collection of textbooks in business, computer science, education, health, science, social science, and it is maintained by University of Georgia. There is another resource which is very good, that is Merlot Advanced Material Search. And this collection consists of tens of thousands of discipline-specific learning materials, learning exercises, and content builder webpage, together with associated comments, bookmark collections, all intended to enhance the teaching experience of using a learning material. All of these items have been contributed by the Merlot member community, which have either authored the material themselves or they have discovered the materials, found them useful, and wish to share their enthusiasm for the materials with others in the teaching learning community. Another example is OpenStax, which is a non-profit educational institution initiative based at Rice University. And it is their mission to give every student the tools they need to be successful in their classroom. Another famous project is Open Textbook for Hong Kong project, which aims to establish a sustainable system which provides quality open textbooks for adoption and adaptation at minimal cost for education for all. The system will serve students and teachers at primary, secondary, and tertiary level. The Open Textbook Project team believes that Open Textbook can solve many of the problems of the traditional printed textbooks in Hong Kong. OER Commons. It forges alliance between trusted content providers and creative users and reusers of OER. So in addition to content partnerships, OER Commons and its creator, Iskeme, builds strategic relationships with organizations, consortia, states, districts, and others in order to develop innovation and new research focused on OER, to advance the field of open education and to build models for its sustainability. Supported in part by the William and Flora Hollett Foundation, Iskeme, the Institute for Study of Knowledge Management in Education, created OER Commons as part of the foundation's worldwide OER initiative. Now let us look at certain OER search engines, and they help us in searching and locating open education materials very easy. Some of the popular OER search engines are, say, OASIS, which is Openly Available Sources Integrated Search. It is a search tool that aims to make discovery of open content easier. OASIS currently searches open content from, say, around 100 of sources and more than 4 lakh records. OASIS is being developed by Sunny Genesco Milne Library. Then we have George Mason OER Meta Finder. It searches several repositories of OER materials. There is another Open Professional Education Network, which saves significant time and effort by reusing existing open educational resources. The open partners recommend tacit grantees invest upfront time finding OER to reuse rather than starting development of new resources right away. A significant benefit of OER is that they provide source materials to build your development efforts around. So no need to invest development efforts in creating something that already exists. Then we have a Timova portal. The word Timova represents the word to seek, investigate, inquire, and comes from Nahuatl language. The Nahuatl is a lingua franca that served as communicative language bridge between people that made up various Mesoamerican cultures. It is a knowledge hub that eases a public and multilingual catalog of open educational resources, which aims to support the education community to find those resources and materials which meet their needs for teaching and learning through a specialized and collaborative search system and social tools. It contains selected educational resources described and evaluated by an academic community, and the resources categorized by area of knowledge, educational level, and language, among others. It also provides a friendly search engine through intuitive filters, and it allows the creation of communities around educational resources. Then Google is there. It is a very powerful tool for making advanced search and how you can make use of Google advanced search is that you go to google.com and in the search box you enter your keyword for that which you want to make your search. Then from the settings tab, as you can see, you can select the advanced search, and in the next screen you provide as much as information for this specific search. Two things are important here. First, your main keyword, and at the bottom of the page you select the usage rights for the kind of open content you want to search. Now, after understanding how we can search, let us see how we can evaluate an OER. As we said previously, there are billions of open educational resources available. In that case, how do you identify the quality of an OER? So some of the parameters which we can adopt are for the evaluation of open educational resources, and particularly the National University of Singapore libraries, it suggests that there are few questions which we should consider while searching for an OER. That is, does this OER cover the content I would like my students to learn in this module? How accessible is that content? Is it too technical or robust and challenging FN for my students? How can I use this content? We need to verify the license that the resource is under. Can we mix or revise this OER as long as it is for non-commercial purpose? And what do you have to acknowledge if you use it? Will you be able to do so? Then once you determine how you can use the OER, what would you like to do with it? Do you need only a portion of it for your class? Or you may want to combine this OER with another OER and another resource. And then you need to think that, does your library have access to materials that could act as supplementary materials? Then you need to think that as you collect more OER and other resources, save them in a central location. Take note of how you plan on using them based on the learning objectives and the weekly lessons on your syllabus in order to identify gaps. So, at the end, I'd like to say the basic principle in case of open educational resources is that there is no need to reinvent the wheel. There are already billions of open source available around us, and therefore, while designing and creating our course as a teacher or to learn a subject, we must first look out for the content available around us on the internet, which we can openly use. We must also bear in mind the quality parameters of an open educational resources. Thank you.